Lesotho Tourism Jazz Festival, also known as Letofi Sounds of Blue, is a music festival that started in 2005 to contribute to the Lesotho tourism and provide world-class festival to the Basotho nation and beyond. The festival has grown immensely since it started and has hosted international acts such as Kenny Lattimore, Andy Narell, Selena Johnson and many more. This year will include artists from both Lesotho and South Africa, which will be hosted in five different venues in Lesotho. Well, to tell us more, we are joined by the organizer, Mundwedi Muledi, and musician, Sands, who is also not a stranger to the show. Gents, it's great to have you both on the program. Thank you so much for coming.
Thank you.
Let me start with you, Mundwedi. I mean, when did this festival kick off? Well, it was in 2005, but when it kicked off, what was the actual vision and the objectives behind starting a festival such as this one?
Okay, thanks. As the name says, it's Lesotho Tourism Festival. Mm-hmm. It was to play a role in the tourism sector mm-hmm. of Lesotho and give Basotho world-class entertainment.
Mm.
That was...
This festival runs over a period of 3 days. So there's lots in store for people who will be making their way to the festival. Take us through each of the days, what will be happening and what people can expect.
Okay. We'll start on a Friday the 20th. There we have what we call 266 Nights with Legends.
Mm-hmm.
There we'll have PJ Powers, mm-hmm. Trompies, Ntando, Manta, and other local artists.
Yes.
Yes. So mainly there we are looking into the old school vibe.
Mm.
And then from there we will move to the main festival, which is known as the Letofi Sounds of Blue.
Yes.
There we'll have Ndati Kaifas, the one that we are honoring this year.
Mm. Mm.
And then Trompies, not Trompies, Freshly Crowned.
Yes.
Tsapo Tsula, Sens here next to me, Vusi Nova, Mwaho, Sidimo, Bongo Muffin, and many more.
Yeah.
So on that day, basically, that's the main festival.
Mm-hmm.
So mm-hmm. we are at least trying as much as possible to have it as a more of a lifestyle festival, not just a music festival. And then on the Sunday, it's a relaxed day where we'll just have a soul session throughout the afternoon.
Mm, okay. I want to chat to the man that's next to you, Sands. Also, when you come to television these days. Is this what being a celebrity is all about?
Dimming the lights.
Yeah, he came here all humble. And now he's a superstar. It's great to have you on the program again. It's been quite a long time.
Mm.
You've had some amazing success with some of the music that you've put out there.
Mm.
What's been happening in your music career?
Well, it's been quite a very busy time.
Yeah.
And recently I just collaborated with Ndati Tsepo Tsula.
Oh, wow.
On a single, which is from my upcoming album, mm-hmm. due to be released next year, early next year. And can't wait to perform it in Lesotho.
So, in Letofi Sounds of Blue, tiki tiki. Now,
it's only...
Yeah.
That's the title of the song.
Ah, Siyathandaza.
Yeah.
Fantastic. So you're going to be a part of this festival. For the people that who will be coming out to the main event to come and see you specifically perform, what do you have in store for those people?
I'm bringing new songs.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, we bring Aswazi Fire. You know, it's quite interesting to have two kingdoms meeting.
Yes, yes.
You know, through music. So we are definitely bringing our best. People should look out for that. And yeah.
You spoke about an album which will be released in the next year. What can people expect? Are you going to stick to the authentic Sand sound that we know you for, or are you going to sort of explore with different sounds to bring something slightly different to the people?
I'm actually still sticking,
mm-hmm.
but do expect more rhythm in this one rather than slower songs.
Yeah.
So we're trying to pump, you know, the energy up.
Mm.
And yeah, it's mostly in Siswati, so... That doesn't change.
Okay, fantastic. Mm. Mundwedi, we're talking about tourism, mm. and I want us now to focus on just the economic benefits of the people in Lesotho when this festival comes around each year. Can you outline just some of those?
Okay. First, if we start with accommodation facilities.
Yeah.
Around Taba Busibu, you'll struggle to have accommodation there.
Mm.
Then you have to stay in Maseru, which is 20-25 kilometers out of.
Yes. Yeah.
So from that angle, accommodation, it's I mean, it's almost full. And then when you go to food and beverages,
yes,
people around the Tawab area, they make good spins out of the out of the festival.
Yeah,
and of course, our tax men.
Yes,
our tax men, so that we can be able to at least contribute to the economy.
All right,
at large, and our artists.
Yes, I was about to say the local artists that are coming through and performing there. Thank you so much, James, for your time. All the best. I know that this festival is going to go well, as it always does. Sans, you must come back and tell us about the new album in the new year. We look forward to seeing you, hopefully without the shades this time, eh? Guys, being famous. Yeah. That was Ndedi Maledi and, of course, Sans speaking to us about the Lesotho Tourism Jazz Festival, which is set to take place in Lesotho this month. Sans is one of the acts that will be performing, but let me tell you, it happens over a three-day period. Kicking off with Legends, the main festival is on Saturday, and of course, lots of fun and excitement happening throughout that three-day period. Make sure you get your tickets, make sure you get all the information, and make sure, of course, that you book, because we did hear that accommodation will be quite tricky, and then you might have to end up staying about 25 kilometers away. So get your tickets, get yourself over there, get to see the beautiful country of Lesotho, and experience the beautiful music from all your favorites. We're going to take a quick break. Stay with us.